The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, indeed, you never leave anything solely for the sake of Allah, except that Allah azza wa jal will replace for you that which is better than it. Better than it. Better than it. You will never leave anything solely for Allah. But it's important that a person does it solely for Allah, not for your wife, not to please your husband, not for the ruler, not for a scholar, not for the imam, not for anyone. You do it solely for Allah azza wa jal. And what you abandon, that thing that was forbidden, you'll be delighted that you abandon it, and you will never miss it. Miss it. Miss it.
In alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruh wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyiati a'malina. Man yahdihillahu fala mudilla lahu wa man yudlil fala hadiya lahu. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu. وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد. Indeed our praise belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him as He deserves to be praised. We ask for His aid and His assistance. We seek His forgiveness. We seek refuge with Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala from the evil of our souls and from the evil of our wicked actions. Whomsoever Allah azza wa jal guides, then none can misguide. Whomsoever Allah Azza wa Jal misguides, then none can guide. I testify that none has the right to be worshipped in truth except Allah Azza wa Jal alone without any partners. And I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his slave and his messenger to Christ. Then my lecture for today is concerning leaving that which is haram, unlawful, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. However, I want to make it broader than that. And this is based upon an authentic hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّكَ لَن تَدَعَ شَيْئًا لِلَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلْ إِلَّا بَدَّلَكَ اللَّهُ بِهِ مَا هُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنْهِ. This hadith, Shaykh al-Albani rahimahullah, declared it to be authentic على شرط صحيح مسلم, على شرط مسلم. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, indeed, you never leave anything solely for the sake of Allah, except that Allah azza wa jal will replace for you that which is better than it. And this is general. If we were to analyze this hadith and break it down into three parts, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, إِنَّكَ لَن تَدَعَ شَيْئًا. Indeed, you will never leave and refrain from anything. So here, anything is عام, is a general statement. As we know, the word شَيْئًا here is نَكِرَ فِي سِيَاقِ النَّفِي, meaning anything that you leave for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. It could be an action, it could be a person, it could be a place. Other than that, إِنَّكَ لَمْ تَدَعَ شَيْئًا. Indeed, you do not leave anything, regardless of what that thing may be. لِلَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلْ. The second part of the hadith, solely for the sake of Allah. That's very important, that you have to leave it solely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I want to share with you a statement of Al-Imam Ibn Al-Qayyim rahimahullah, because sometimes a person may leave something that is haram, or may leave someone that is not beneficial for them, or may leave a particular place, but they may find long-term difficulty. Then we have to analyze what was the reason why they refrained or they left off this thing. Because if they've done it for Allah, they would not find that they experienced long-term suffering. That's why Al-Imam Ibn Al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he said, إنما يجب المشقة في ترك المألوفات والعوائد من تركها لغير الله. الإمام ابن القيم رحمه الله تعالى, he said, a person only finds it difficult to abandon habits and customary behavior when they leave them for other than Allah's sake. So if someone left something for other than Allah Azza wa Jal, then yes, they're going to find it difficult. If you do it to make just to please someone or to make someone else happy, you're going to find some mashaqqa, some difficulty, some hardship. And it may be long term because you didn't leave it for Allah. That's why the Prophet said, إِنَّكَ لَن تَدَعَ شَيْئًا لِلَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلِ. Indeed, you never leave anything solely for Allah, the Mighty Majestic. So when we leave something, we have to make sure that we leave it for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala alone. And that is the sole reason. And Al-Imam Ibn Al-Qayyim said, rahimahullah, as we mentioned, إِنَّمَا يَجِدَ الْمَشَّقَّ فِي تَرْكِ الْمَأْلُوفَاتِ وَالْعَوَائِمْ مَنْ تَرَكَهَا لِغَيْرِ اللَّهِ فَأَمَّا مَنْ تَرَكَهَا الصَّادِقًا مُخْلِصًا مِنْ قَلْبِهِ لِلَّهِ فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَجِدْ فِي تَرْكِهَا مَشَقَّةً إِلَّا فِي أَوَّلِ وَهْلَةٍ. As for the person who leaves these things truthfully and sincerely with his heart for Allah Azza wa Jal alone, then he will not find it difficult, except at the very beginning. At the very beginning, yes. However, in the long term, you will find it is easy because Allah Azza wa Jal will make it easy because you left it for his sake, tabaraka wa ta'ala. And that's why Imam Ibn Al-Qayyim said, rahimahullah, he said, and the reason why a person may find that it is difficult at the beginning, but it will become easy at the end, he said, فَإِنْ صَبْرَ عَلَى تِلْكَ الْمَشَقَّ قَلِيلًا إِسْتَحَالَ النَّدَّ لِيُمْتَحَنْ أَصَادِقُ هُوَ فِي تَرْكِهَا أَمْ كَاذِبٌ. And this is to test that maybe at the beginning, the initial stages, a small amount of hardship for a short period of time to differentiate between the one who is truthful in abandoning these things for Allah and the one who is pretending. To differentiate between the one who is truthful and abandoning these things for Allah and the one who is lying. And he said, if he is patient with that difficulty for a short period of time, it will transform into enjoyment and pleasure in delight. And it's very important, this part of the hadith, lillah, that you leave it solely for Allah Azza wa Jalla. Remember the hadith in Sahih Muslim, narrated by Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, so it's a hadith Qudsi. Allah said, أَنَا أَغْنَى الشُّرَكَاءِ عَنِ الشِّرْكِ. I am free from having any partners. Allah said, I am free from having any partners. مَنْ عَمِلَ عَمَلًا أَشْرَكَ مَعِي. Whoever does an action, أَشْرَكَ فِيهِ مَعِي غَيْرِي تَرَكْتُهُ وَشِرْكَ. Whoever does an action and they associate partners with me in this action, I will leave that person and I will leave that shirk. I will abandon them. So if someone does something for other than Allah, Allah Azza wa Jalla said, مَنْ عَمِلَ عَمَلًا أَشْرَكَ فِيهِ مَعِي غَيْرِي. Whoever does an action and he associates partners with me, he does it for somebody else, I will abandon that person and I will leave his shirk. Now that's, if Allah leaves a person, that person is on a path to destruction. May Allah protect us from that. If Allah leaves and abandons a person, the person is going to find difficulty and hardship. That is why in the supplication of the Prophet ﷺ, the Prophet would say, supplicating to Allah Azza wa Jal, فَلَا تَكِلْنِي إِلَى نَفْسِي طَرْفَةَ عَيْنٍ. Do not leave me to my own self for the blink of an eye. Do not leave me to my own self even for the blinking of an eye. Because if Allah leaves the servant even for a blinking of an eye, that's going to be a period of difficulty and burden and sadness. May Allah protect us all from that. So that was the second part of the hadith. Remember the hadith, and again we'll go back to it. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّكَ لَن تَدَعَ شَيْئًا لِلَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلْ إِلَّا بَدَّلَكَ اللَّهُ بِهِ مَا هُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنْهِ. That you never leave anything for Allah Azza wa Jal, solely for Allah, the last part, except that Allah will replace it with that which is better for you. Allahu Akbar. Imam al-Sa'di rahimahullah, he mentions this in one of his books as the 69th qa'idah. And he said there are many verses that we find this principle present in the Quran. Even this principle, man taraka shay'an lillah, generally, and we mentioned the wording of the hadith, whoever leaves something for Allah, Allah will replace it with that which is better. Al-Imam al-Sa'di said that it's found in the Quran in many places. We will give, inshallah ta'ala, we will give some examples of that. Examples of how people left something for Allah and Allah gave them better than that. From the book of Allah Azza wa Jalla, the Quran. The last part of the hadith, بَدَّلَكَ اللَّهُ بِهِ مَا هُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنْ. Allah will replace it with that which is better for you. And let's give another example. Now, That comes in the hadith in Sahihain, in Bukhari and Muslim, and in hadith Qudsi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, وَإِن تَرَكَهَا مِنْ أَجْلِي. If the servant leaves off a bad deed for my sake, فَاكْتُبُوهَا حَسَنًا. Record it as a good deed. Look, if the servant abandons an evil deed for my sake, Allah Azza wa Jalla said, في هذا الحديث القدسي, فَاكْتُبُوهَا. Allah commands the angels to record that deed, to write it down as a good deed. So look, the servant left something for Allah, Allah recorded that what? As a good deed. You have ajr, there's reward. Because you stayed away from something, why? And it mentions in the hadith, whoever leaves it, min ajli, for my sake alone. Faktubuha, record this now as a good deed. Because the servant left off that thing for who? For Allah Azza wa Jalla alone, without any promise. Likewise, one of the examples that we can give, as it relates to what we mentioned here, this hadith. And this is what one of the examples that Imam al-Sa'di rahimahullah said is present in the Quran. An example of whoever leaves something for Allah, sincerity for Allah. Remember the statement of Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah. It has to be solely for Allah, as we find in the hadith. Because if it's not for Allah, you're going to find what? Hardship. It's going to be difficult. Long term. But if you do it for Allah Azza wa Jalla, in the long term, it will be something that is pleasurable, something delightful. At the beginning, the initial stage is for a short period of time. Yes, there may be some hardship, but that's only to determine who is true and who is pretending. One of the examples we find is in the Quran, and I think I mentioned this to you briefly, maybe in a different mas'ala, the story of Prophet Yusuf, alayhi salatu wasalam, Joseph, alayhi salatu wasalam. Now, Yusuf, he refrained. When the woman, she tried to seduce him, a woman of beauty, Naam, a woman of position, she tried to seduce Yusuf and call him and invite him to illicit and immoral relations. And remember, Yusuf was young. Yusuf was single. Yusuf was a stranger in that land. But he refrained because he feared Allah Azza wa Jalla, and he abandoned that for Allah, and Allah Azza wa Jalla elevated him in this world, and Allah Azza wa Jalla tabarak wa ta'ala promised him an immense reward in the Akhirah. Allah Azza wa Jalla says in the Quran, informs us in the Quran about the story of Yusuf. There's a whole surah in the Quran, surah to Yusuf. The story of Yusuf. After the women tried to seduce him, after the wife of the Aziz, she tried to seduce him and force him to have relations with her. Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, he said, رَبِّ السِّجْنُ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّا يَدْعُونَنِي إِلَيْهِ وَإِلَّا تَصْرِفْ عَنِّي كَيْدَوْنَّ أَصْبُ إِلَيْهِنَّ وَأَكُمْ مِنَ الْجَاهِلِينَ. He said, oh my Lord, prison is more beloved to me than what they are inviting me to. And if you do not turn their plot away from me, I may incline to them for what they desire, and I will be from among the ignorant. Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, he turned away from that for Allah Azza wa Jalla. He feared Allah Azza wa Jalla, tabarak wa ta'ala, and Allah Azza wa Jalla, tabarak wa ta'ala, elevated him in the earth, as Allah Azza wa Jalla says in the Quran, وَكَذَلِكَ مَكَّنَّا لِيُوسَفَ فِي الْأَرْضِ يَتَبَوَّأُ مِنْهَا حَيْثُ يَشَاءُ. We gave Yusuf authority in the earth. We gave Yusuf authority in the earth. He could go where he pleased. Yusuf, Allah Azza wa Jalla gave him authority. Allah Azza wa Jalla gave him position. Allah Azza wa Jalla tabarak wa ta'ala gave him a pleasurable life. And on top of that, Allah Azza wa Jalla gave him immense reward and promised him immense reward in the Akhirah. So Allah Azza wa Jalla gave him the good of this world, and Allah Azza wa Jalla promised him the good of the Akhirah, a great reward. So that's another example. How Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, he turned away from that immoral behavior when the woman, she tried to seduce him. He feared Allah Azza wa Jalla, and Allah what? He replaced it with that which was better. Better in this world and better in the Akhirah. Because yes, sometimes you may be given something better in this world. It may be the same thing that you're given better, and it's in the same area, or it may be in a different area. Naam. Another example that we find in the book of Allah Azza wa Jal, which shows us and highlights the correctness of this principle. Whoever leaves something for Allah Azza wa Jalla, Allah will replace it with that which is better. And as we said, likewise, it is found in the Quran, and we mentioned the clear hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The story of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Abraham, when Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, he left his people, he left his father, and that which they worship besides Allah Azza wa Jalla, Allah tells us in the Quran that he gifted him with Ishaq and Ya'qub and a righteous offspring. Allah Azza wa Jalla described Ibrahim one man on his own as a ummah, as a nation, obedient to Allah Azza wa Jalla. So when Ibrahim left his people for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jalla, and he abandoned what they worship besides Allah, Allah blessed him and he bestowed upon him Ishaq and Ya'qub, and he gave him a righteous offspring. And he made him an imam, a leader among mankind. That's the story of Ibrahim. Are there other examples? Yes, there are other examples. If we look, likewise, with regards to the hijrah of the Prophet ﷺ, the migration of the Prophet ﷺ and the companions, when they migrated from Mecca to Medina. Because in Mecca, they were persecuted, they were tortured. Why? Because they said, La ilaha illallah, none has the right to be worshipped in truth except Allah. They were persecuted, some of them were tortured. We gave the talk previously in Trinidad about Sumayya, radiallahu anha, the first martyr in Islam. She was stabbed by Abu Jahl in a private. Why? Because she said, La ilaha illallah, a woman who was patient with torture and punishment that many men could not tolerate. And she was the first martyr in Islam. So in Mecca, it was a period of persecution, a period of hardship. So the Muslims, they migrated. The first migration was to Abyssinia. Then after that, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they migrated to what? Al-Madinah. So when they migrated, the companions, the Muhajirun, from Mecca to Al-Madinah, remember, they left their homes, they left their wealth, they left their family, but they left it for Allah Azza wa Jalla, tabaraka wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he tells us in the Quran, وَمَنْ يُهَاجِرْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ يَجِدْ فِي الْأَرْضِ مُرَاغَمًا كَثِيرًا وَسَعًا وَمَنْ يَخْرُجْ مِنْ بَيْتِهِ مُهَاجِرًا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ ثُمَّ يُدْرِكْهُ الْمَوْتِ فَقَدْ وَقَعَ أَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا. Whoever migrates for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will find many dwellings in the earth, and they will find vast sustenance. And whoever leaves their house migrating, look, to Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So remember, we said it has to be done for Allah. It has to be done sincerely. Because if you do it for another reason, you're only going to attain what you were looking for from the affairs of the dunya. You may attain that, but that's all you're going to get. Remember the hadith, إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَاتِ, the first hadith in Bukhari, actions are judged according to the intention. وَإِنَّمَا لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مَا نَوَى, and every person will receive what they intended. فَمَنْ كَانَتْ هِجْرَتُهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ فَهِجْرَتُهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. Whoever's migration was for Allah and His Messenger, then his migration, yes, it was for Allah and His Messenger. وَمَنْ كَانَتْ هِجْرَتُهُ لِلدُّنْيَا لِيُسِيبُهَا وَامْرَأَةٍ يَنْكِحُهَا فَهِجْرَتُهُ إِلَى مَا هَاجَرَ إِلَيْهِ. If someone migrated just for the dunya, or someone migrated just to marry a woman, then their migration was for that. That's all they're going to get from it, nothing else. So actions are judged according to the intentions. So Allah Azza wa Jalla said in this ayah, whoever migrates for Allah Azza wa Jalla, they will find many dwelling places, but it has to be done solely for Allah. And they will find vast provisions. Also what? Allah said, whoever leaves their house, migrating for Allah and His Messenger, they're sincere, then they die on the way, then their reward is incumbent upon Allah. Allah Azza wa Jalla made it obligatory upon Himself that He will reward them, even though they never completed it. Look at the benefit of having a sincere and a pure intention. Even though they never completed the action, Allah will still give them the reward because of their intention. Then the reward is with Allah Azza wa Jalla, and Allah is of forgiving, the most merciful. That's why Imam Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he mentioned, he said, وَلَمَّا تَرَكَ الْمُهَاجِرُونَ دِيَارَهُمْ لِلَّهِ وَأَوْطَانَهُمْ أَلَّتِي هِيَ أَحَبُّ شَيْءٍ إِلَيْهِمْ أعاقهم الله أم فتح عليهم الدنيا. He said, when the Muhajirun left their homes and their lands for the sake of Allah, and these things that they left were some of the most beloved things to them, Allah replaced this by opening up for them the world. He gave them leadership over the East and the West. Allah opened open for the companions the world. Because they left their homes, their loved ones, and their wealth for Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala. And they were sincere in that. So look, we see an example of that, what was mentioned in that hadith. And as we said, it's a general principle found in many verses in the Quran. إِنَّكَ لَمْ تَدَعَ شَيْئًا لِلَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلِ. You will never leave anything sincerely for Allah's sake. إِلَّا بَدَّلَكَ اللَّهُ بِهِ مَا هُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنْ. Except Allah will give you better than that. You will never leave anything solely for Allah, except Allah will give you better than that. Let's take, and we'll close with this, the story of one of the companions, Suhaib al-Rumi, Suhaib the Roman. And again, this shows the importance of leaving something for Allah Azza wa Jalla, but the great reward that is a consequence of that, that Allah Azza wa Jalla will give the servant, and how Allah Azza wa Jalla will elevate the servant in this life, and how Allah Azza wa Jalla will reward them in the Akhirah and the hereafter. Suhaib al-Rumi, radiallahu anhu, he migrated from Mecca to Medina. But when he left Mecca, tabi'ahu ahlu Mecca min al-mushrikeen. The people of Mecca, the mushrikun, they chased after him and they went in pursuit, meaning to capture him, because they wanted to prevent him migrating to Medina to be with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Suhaib, he pulled out some of his arrows from the arrow case. He pulled out 40, and he said to them, he said, none of you will approach me and be able to come near me, except that I will put in every man from among you an arrow. And he said that once the arrows are finished, he said, then I will use the sword. And he said, you know certainly I'm a man, meaning I can defend myself. But then he said to them, he said, I left in Mecca, I left wealth. If you let me go on my way, look, he just wanted to go to be with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He wanted to migrate for Allah. He said, if you let me go on my way, you can have all my wealth that's in Mecca. Look at that. Look at what he was willing to give up. What are we willing to give up for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jalla, and to promote the religion of truth, or for our well-being in this world and the well-being of that in the Akhirah? Some people, they can't give up 5 minutes to pray, or 10 minutes to make salah. Some people, they can't give up the pillow to wake up. Some people, they can't take time to go and learn how to pray or to recite Fatiha. Look, the companions. That's why when people talk about the problems that we have in the Muslim world or among the Muslims today, it's because of us. The religion is true. Allah's promise is true. But the deficiency is with us. When the companions implemented the commands of Allah, when they implemented the commands of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when they left things for Allah, look how Allah honored them. Look how Allah Azza wa Jalla tabarak wa ta'ala fulfilled his promise, and Allah never breaks his promise. So any deficiency is with us, not with the religion of Islam. So Suhaib, he said to them, he said, I have wealth in Mecca. Let me go upon my journey, because that's all he wanted. And you can have it, it's yours. So on the back of that, a verse was revealed. Does anyone know what ayah was revealed? Does anyone know what verse from the Quran was revealed? The verse that was revealed, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَشْرِي نَفْسَهُ ابْتِغَاءَ مَرْضَاتِ اللَّهِ. Some people, they sell themselves seeking the pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Some people, they sell themselves seeking the pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jalla. So Suhaib, obviously, when this incident happened, he didn't know that the verse was revealed. When he went to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave him the glad tidings about the ayah being revealed, he said to him, "Oh Abu Yahya, your sale has been very profitable, meaning your exchange. You gave them that wealth, and look, a verse was revealed about you. A verse that will be recited until the hour is established, that we recite today. We talk about Suhaib al-Rumi today. How many people do you know from that era that exists that we're still talking about? How many people from 200 years ago, do you know any of their names? Can you mention one person? Forget about 200. Give me a name for somebody in Tobago 100 years ago. Anyone? Look, we're still talking about Suhaib radiallahu anhu today. A verse of the Quran was revealed about him radiallahu anhu. Allah Azza wa Jalla praised him, said that he was a man who was willing to sell himself seeking the pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jalla. And we know why? It was referring to what? When he gave all of his wealth away because he wanted to migrate to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because he was sincere to Allah Azza wa Jalla. So no doubt, brothers and sisters, إِنَّكَ لَن تَدَعَ شَيْئًا لِلَّهِ, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, you will never leave anything solely for Allah. But it's important that a person does it solely for Allah, not for your wife, not for you to please your husband, not for the ruler, not for a scholar, not for the imam, not for anyone. You do it solely for Allah Azza wa Jalla. And what you abandon, that thing that was forbidden, you'll find in the long term, it will be something you will find pleasure that you abandon that thing. You'll be delighted that you abandon it, and you will never miss it if you do it for Allah Azza wa Jalla. If someone does something for other than Allah, I'm doing it, you know, just to make my husband happy, or I'm doing it just to make my wife happy, or I'm doing it just to make the imam happy, or I'm doing it just for such and such, or I'm doing it just for the dunya, yes, you're going to find difficulty. That's why some people, you see them along the path, they lose their way. Maybe sometimes it goes back to because of the intention in the beginning. May Allah Azza wa Jalla make us sincere and purify our hearts and our intentions. I don't want to go on too long. Alhamdulillah, you'll be very patient. And we'll let him the first talk, jazakallah khairan, because it required that level of detail. It was, you know, a significant period of time. So I'll suffice with that. May Allah Azza wa Jalla bless us to benefit from what we heard and to implement it. Wa jazakumullah khairan wa barakallahu feekum. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.